Sure. So we kind of seeked out people who work in the industry, people who've had years of experience working at a Foot Locker or a consignment shop, guys who touch and feel shoes on a daily basis, comparing reals and fakes.
What do you say to someone who justifies buying a fake by saying, you know, it looks the same, but it costs a lot less?
If they're extremely happy with buying a fake, there's not much that we can kind of change their mind. We'll do our best to educate why they shouldn't be buying fakes. You're supporting basically crooks.
Alright, he's going left to center now, so we're gonna stop him. Keeps reaching over to the right.
Afternoon, sir. Also, Jet Police. The reason I stopped you, keep traveling left to center. Is everything okay?
Oh, yeah, I'm using my e-brake. I'm on my way to go get my brakes right now.
Oh, you are? Okay, you got a driver's license, registration, proof of insurance?
Any weapons in the vehicle?
No. How much marijuana is in the vehicle?
No, sir.
None? There's a very strong odor of marijuana.
Okay, when's the last time you smoked? All right, ignore that and speak to me. How long has it been since you smoked?
A few days.
A few days? All right, go ahead and undo your seatbelt for me and step out. Okay. Listen to me. You're going to get hurt. Do you understand? Grab for anything, you're going to be hurt. Face away from me. Face away from me and do it now. He's trying to tough choke on me.
I have a knife in my pocket.
I know you do. Approaching the vehicle, he's avoiding me. He keeps saying, give me a second, reaching down. Now, you made this a situation that it didn't have to be. All right, so how much more marijuana do you have?
I'm a minor. I'd like my mother's present.
Okay. Well, you're under arrest at this time, okay? At this point, we're going to search the vehicle due to the marijuana. All right, step back here for me. Just put it in my car.
It's an airsoft gun, but he's got the marijuana bag for sale.
Am I allowed to revoke my board for 15 minutes?
Yeah, you don't have to say anything.
Okay.
Where was the scale at, Captain?
You don't have no console where the 20 gun was located.
Hey, officer? Yes. I thought you were invoking your Fourth Amendment. Does the state law give me the right if I detect the odor of marijuana to search the vehicle?
It is a Ruger 22 long rifles caliber. All right, so at this point we've located a actual real firearm. We've got a minor dealing marijuana with scales and money and a firearms.
A little Pineapple Express. The subject has 8 bags of marijuana, approximately I'd say a pound.
It's high-grade marijuana. It's actually labeled Pineapple Express. So, at this point, he's under arrest for dealing in marijuana, possession of a firearm without a permit. This goes to show that you never know what you're going to get into out here. I'm going to put your wallet back in here, sir. The vehicle's going to be impounded. He's going to go to jail. It'll be up to the court system, juvenile detention, and his parents to what happens.
Back in those days, I didn't have an artist to work with. I would go to Jimmy's house and have listening sessions. He was trying to help me figure out where I was going to go with my music. He would take me down to his garage. There was cassette tapes everywhere. And I remember him picking up this cassette tape. He pops this in. And I was like, what the fuck and who the fuck is that? One, say that again.
When you roll 90% of it, what you need to do is practice on your freestyles. When you come on this it says to me, I saw this guy at the rap battle last night. I said, if you get me a CD, I will give it to Dre.
Please don't like this bloody video, Quino! Give me that motherfucking mic!
Boom. In comes my Caucasian partner. Let's cut to the fucking chase, man.
Let's cut to the chase. Put me in when you first meet Dre. What happens?
I just want to be known as a legitimate MC. And that's all I could have ever hoped for. You know, to put food on the table, doing what I love to do, would be the ultimate goal. I remember I would just take different trips to anywhere I could, just trying to make any kind of name and pass out my sets. I was just really down that I had got all the way to the end at Rap Olympics and lost. This kid came up to me and was like, hey man, can I get one of your tapes? And I think I probably just, you know, whatever. Okay, so fast forward to, holy shit, I'm in the Interscope office. Holy shit, this is Jimmy Iovine. Holy shit, Dr. Dre just walked in. Holy shit, I just shit myself. I'm pissing myself now, thinking about it. Yeah, I'm pissing right now. So, Eminem comes in this bright yellow fucking sweatsuit. Hoodie, pants, everything is bright fucking yellow. I'm like, wow. I'm looking at Dre like, dude, I see you on TV all the time. You one of my biggest influences ever in life. I'm like, man, listen, I think this shit is fucking incredible and I would love to work with you. You know, I had a studio in my house at the time and I went and put some samples together, did a couple of things at the drum machine. I invited him over.
Dre, you do a lot of recording here?
Yeah. Like, man, listen, I put this sample together. Tell me if you like it.
Mm-hmm. My joints move, yeah.
And I hit the drum machine. And maybe 2 or 3 seconds went by. And he just went, hi, my name is. Like, yo, stop. Shit's hot. That's what happened. On the first day, and the first few minutes of us being in the studio.
Stop the tape. This kid needs to be locked away.
So he starts singing this hook, and I'm in love with it. All of a sudden, I'm like, okay, I gotta go through my recording process. I think some cuts over the hook.
Yeah, it sounds like it's a hook.
This is the greatest producer. I'm in his fucking house recording. I don't know shit about nothing. I just wanted to make sure that every beat that he played for me, I had a rhyme ready to go.
Hi, kids.
Out of Dre, and he's laughing, he's not discouraging me for pushing buttons.
My brain said, wait, I'm trying to get my head straight, but I can't figure out which Spice Girl I want to impregnate.
I'm blown the fuck away. It's just one of those things when you just know something special is happening. I'm rushing, I'm trying to get this thing recorded because sometimes as a producer, you can feel when the magic is happening. You don't want the artist to lose this, so I don't want to lose this momentum.
Dre saw himself as different. When Eminem came in and he heard that same angst, that same attitude, and he said, oh, that's what I do.
It was fucking magic. Dre called me up and said, I got this kid, we gotta sign him like today. Now in the record business, generally contracts take 2 months. Dre goes, I don't lose this guy, he's unbelievable, we gotta get this guy signed. My gut told me Eminem was the artist that I'm supposed to be working with right now. But I didn't know how many racists I had around me.
Everybody except me, here I am. Please accept me, I beg you for acceptance. This is Eminem, please.
Coming up in the scene as a battle rapper, I had been through a lot of moments that were like this and ended up being like this. Because, you know, it's everything was telling him, don't fuck with him. Everybody around me, so-called execs and what have you, were all against it. The records that I had done at the time, they didn't work. They wanted me out the building. And then I come up with Eminem, this white boy.
Me, Slim Shady.
My general manager had this 8x10 picture and was like, Dre, this boy's got blue eyes. What are we doing?
We were looking for a white controversial rapper. We were looking for greats.
I go back to Detroit, fucking bummed out, and I remember just thinking, this is
trusted Drake.
It's just like, okay, fuck it, I'm throwing the dice. I'm betting all the marbles on Eminem. I knew he was taking a risk, but I just didn't know how much internal shit he was fighting. You know, I owe him my life for that. No bullshit, like, I know you risked it all for me.
Young niggas really fucking yeah. time. Regular show.
You were on regular show, right?
Yeah, I was.
I'm fucked. They made me short as fuck. And that nigga, what's his name? Donald Glover nigga, that nigga way shorter than me. I'm a fucking man.
What the fuck are you mad,
sir? Shut up.
We have my favorite part? I think Elijah might have my favorite part. Stevie, too. He killed him. Fucking sick. They don't know what the fuck we're talking about right now. That's awesome. Probably not, man. I'm fucking, I like keeping my shit like this. Like, no outside niggas, no, I like keeping all my shit fucking tight. I do have outside features on the album, but those are people that, like, I was 5 years old when I heard Erykah Badu's first album. I've been a Pharrell fucking stan since I can fucking remember. I've been in love with Stereo Lab since fucking high school. Like I've worked with people on there that influenced my music. Like, I basically copied from them. So I made sure that fucking if I could fucking possibly get them to work with me, and I've been copying their music for years, I'm gonna fucking do it. The only people now is Roy Ayers and Eminem, and I'm good. Now, I actually don't like when people say, is the album good? Like, I don't know. Like, we have different tastes. Like, how can I... I like it personally, but like you might not like it. Like, there's always some dude wearing some stupid shirt that I wouldn't like. Like, so it's kind of like, it's a weird question. Like, is Tyler, is the album good? Well, if I say yes, you're obviously probably gonna not like it because of your fucking stupid ass pink dolphin shirt, you fucking idiot.
It's two white dudes with their hands up. I don't know what's going on.
So they say the front name is Dave Murphy, and then we drive all you guys previously.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Oh, shit. Asians are here.
White things I say in hip-hop, that's fucking sick. I was making this so proud of me, baby. Surely I just want to dance.
So here you have tires, then you have a front like a regular go-kart. This engine will be eco-friendly, electric, and green. Green. Green for the earth and the birds.
Building a go-kart out of one-wheel components is going to be a bit of a challenge. The motor is actually in the wheel. You know, one wheel, you just control one individual motor at a time. But now we're going to have to control four of them all together, going the right direction at the right speed. This idea is probably crazy. is gonna be like real life Super Mario Kart.
Who's this?
Fucking 8-hour drive to fucking Floopy Land. Get there, and I see this little chair thing. I'm like, oh, this must be like some random mock-up thing.
What are you gonna call it?
This will be called the San Clemente Diablo.
The San Clemente Diablo. Yes.
And the secret name that only me and Jasper will call this is Mark.
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 They made the fucking steering wheel a PlayStation 2 controller. It's 2030, and they still have access to a fucking PlayStation 2 controller? How dare you?
fuck's sake.